Shri Saptagiri Ulka Ji.
Thank you, Chairman Ma'am. I rise to speak on the Mines and Minerals Development Regulation Amendment Bill 2021. Sir, ye pura mines, before I start on the bill, let's have a different perspective. I come from Odisha, which is one of the major states in mining. And it is also a predominantly a tribal region with a lot of people who are affected in mines are mostly tribals. And if you look at all the firing or the protests which happened, you look at the Kalinganagar, 12 tribals were killed in police firing when they protested. Mykonj also, 3 people were killed when they protested. So basically, if you look at this, mostly it affects tribals. And when I come to Odisha, almost 25% of India's iron and manganese ore resources will be up for sale for captive uses. By doing so, the Odisha, the projected steel capital of India, would become the principal provider to India's target 300 million ton steel capacity by 2030. And it has a direct influence on India's economy, no doubt. It will propel the India's economy by 2.1% of GDP will be contributed by all the mines in Odisha. And definitely the $5 trillion economy dream which PM Modi has been envisaging. Odisha is a major contributor in all these mine activities, but we are called Ratna Bhandar, like we are filled with mines and all. But over the soil, I'll tell you some statistics about Odisha. Like mining is not something new. Before 2015 also there was mining, and it has been going on for a long time. Despite its riches, Odisha unemployment rate is 7.1%. It's more than the national average. And the estimated asset of the people is around 2.81 lakhs, which is lower than national income. Agriculture production is sharply decreasing. The only trades that mines had incurred, well, like mostly, what are the kind of employment opportunity you have? The automobile, rentals, logistics, hospitalities, and brokering. Our youths, they're present, they're neither present in upstream or downstream activities. There's a lot of mining boom, but we don't have jobs for the local youths in Odisha. It's in the bottom in the health index score, and all the mineralist districts of state are featured in India's most backward districts. Most of the districts are aspirational districts. I'll tell you an example. Keunjhar, which is the epicenter of mining, 62% of the population lives below the poverty line. Koraput, which I represent, is the Asia's bauxite capital, 90% bauxite reserves in Asia, where we have Nalco, Utkal, and a lot of mines there. There we have 79% who live below the poverty line. The income from this mineral extraction has not benefited the region. And there's a reason behind it, and rather what I see is that after the mining boom, the region has become more and more poor. Poverty has increased. And if you look at the ecological thing, like how it has impacted the environment and all, Brahmani is a large river, length of 701 kilometer. It is the second largest river of Odisha, and is the most polluted river in Odisha also, and it's one of the 10 most polluted rivers in India. And according to the study by the Institute for Policy Studies, the greenhouse gas emissions from Odisha makes up nearly 1% of global emissions. And one of the major reasons what is impacting the people here is this uprooting of thousands of people who are Adivasis. Like most of the mine area, they belong to Adivasis, and we are forced to give our lands to non-Adivasi peoples. Another study contests that in Koraput district alone, around 100,000 Adivasis were disposed of their land, including 1.6 lakh hectares of forest land. And most of the Adivasis, as you know, they live on forest land for non-forest timber products, the cultivation and all. They don't have their land and everything. And one of the mining sector generated employment, I'll tell you again, it has not increased. If you look at our areas, like my districts and all, employment has gone up because we don't have employment. They're not skilled. They're unskilled people, and they don't get an employment opportunity. Most of the people, the entrepreneurs also who come into mining, they're outside the state. And perhaps not surprising, Odisha, the most mined districts, Jajpur, Keunjhar, Denkanal, Angul, Jharsuguda, Sundargarh, Mayurbhanj, Koraput, and Raigada, which are under my constituency, they're the poorest district in the state. And dramatic impact on the community organizers and so on. So what I would say is that I understand the government is cash-strapped. They want to increase the revenues and everything. But we have to look at a holistic level, like what exactly, like the human index, the human factor of it. Is it actually by mining, is it good? for the country with the people are developing or not. I'll tell you, sir, on the points in the bill. I'll tell you specifically example of DM, District Mineral Fund, which you have brought in. This is very good that you want to increase the MPs. I am a part of the DMF in my state, Koraput and Raigada. But you know what the kind of projects they used to do? They used to paint walls of the railway walls, they used to do paintings, gardens, they used to have toy trains and everything. We have changed that. And any recommendation that you give or direction you give, definitely you should make the local MP as the chairman of the DMF so that we can at least overlook what kind of spend is happening and let the revenues be with the states, but let the MP be a part of the chairman. That is one thing. The adverse impact on environment, sir, mining, when you talk about mining and everything, so after 30, 40 years, the reserves will go out and it will be a dump. Nothing will be there, and the environment is something, biodiversity, the Ministry of Environment is also here. You should work in very close collaboration, and I would request you also, the tribal minister, Sri Arjun Munda, should be also be part of this group. Because when you come for mining, it's very nice that when you see there's petrol in someone else's house, you like to extract it. But if it comes to your own house, I come from the place, if you ask me to get out of my house, it's very difficult. And you need to rehabilitate the people. You look into the environment diversity and all. The federal structure of the state by awarding power to the union government to auction of mines. So once this is one clause in this particular bill. If the state government is not able to do the auction, then you give it, you take over. So we need to understand what is the process, what are the timelines when the state government is not able to auction the mines. This is something which you need to clarify in the rules. District Mineral Foundation, I already spoke about. This is a very good fund and very required, and let it not be like MP Lads. We had MP Lads where we could oversee what kind of development we used to have. Now I don't know my 5 crores for this year, 5 crores next year, where is going to be spent. If the District Mineral Fund is spent in that area, then we welcome this. Whatever measures you do, you make sure that the people's representatives, MPs and MLAs and the Sarpanch, the Gram Sabhas are involved in this. There's one point, the removal of restriction on end-user minerals. The Act empowers the central government to reserve any mine other than coal, lignite and atomic minerals to be leased through an auction for a particular end-use. Such mines are known as captive mines. The bill provides that no mine will be reserved for particular end use. Sir, captive mines, I'll tell you the history of it. Sir, jab koi mines aap public hearing mein jaate hai, Gram Sabha mein ye pesh aata hai, to ek, for example, ek area, I'll give an example, Kodinga Mali hai, for example. To jab public hearing mein jaate hai, aap agar humare mines le rahe hain, jo impacted villages hai periphery mein, wo log chahenge ki aap mines khali leke hame DMF nahi chahiye, hame rozgar chahiye, we need employment, we need development in the area, hospitals in the area. तो जब तक ये कैप्टिव माइंस आप नहीं देते हो तो कोई कंपनी वहाँ पे प्लांट सेटअप नहीं करेगा. अब कोडिंग माली से अगर कैप्टिव माइंस का आप नहीं दोगे तो वहाँ पे जो अपना कंसारीगुड़ा में प्लांट. आई हैव 15 मिनट्स मैम, आई वाज प्रॉमिस 15 मिनट्स, ही स्पोकन वे मच फ्यू मैम, सो आई हैव 15 मिनट्स. आई
So
okay, just seek your diligence, right. Give me 4-5 minutes, I'll wrap it up.
Please
no
wrap
problem.
It up.
Sir, the captive mines is really important. I'll tell you, just like Kamsariguda, a plant. The Hindalco, they wanted to set up a plant, so they wanted this Kodingamali mines. Agar wo mines ab nikal ke, if you sell it to other companies, reserves kitna hai? There's 90 million ton per total reserves, and 3 million ton already ab, ye extraction chal raha hai. If you give it 6 million ton karoge, to fir wo plant banega hi nahi wahan pe. To isliye wo captive mines ki zarurat hai. And transfer of statutory clearance. Upon expiry of mining lease, mines are leased to new person through auction. And aap kya kar rahe, jab auction ho jata hai, jo statutory clearance se, wo bhi aap transfer kar rahe. Sir, nahi sir, aap agar ye lease khatam hota hai, koi naya bidder aata hai auction ke liye, to ye gram sabha, police sabha fir se karaiye. क्योंकि जो नया बिडर है वो क्या चाहता है क्या नहीं चाहता है वो लोगों का मत भी आपको लेना चाहिए कि ग्राम सभा में ये होना चाहिए. आप ये राइट्स ऑफ सर्टेन एग्जिस्टिंग कंसेशन होल्डर्स इन 2015 एक्ट, द एक्ट वाज अमेंडेड टू प्रोवाइड दैट माइंस विल बी लीज्ड थ्रू एन ऑक्शन प्रोसेस. यू गेव एन एक्सेप्शन टू राइट टू ऑब्टेन प्रोस्पेक्टिंग लाइसेंस, जिसका प्रोस्पेक्टिंग लाइसेंस और माइनिंग लीज है, टू होल्डर ऑफ रिकनाइसेंस परमिट और प्रोस्पेक्टिंग लाइसेंस, जो पहले से ऑलरेडी प्रोस्पेक्टिंग कर रहे हैं, रिकंस्ट्रक्ट कर रहे हैं, जो स्टडी करके एक्सप्लोरेशन कर रहे हैं, उनको ये छूट दिया गया था. बट इसमें आप उसको हटा रहे हो. सर दिस इज़ अ वेलकम स्टेप बट वी नीड टू, आई गिव यू अ केस. देयर इज़ वन कंपनी विच हैड गॉट दिस प्रोस्पेक्टिंग लाइसेंस इन 1992 फॉर कुट्रामाली एंड सिरजीमाली माइंस इन केबीके डिस्ट्रिक्ट, दैट इज इन रायगढ़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट. 1990s वो पड़े हुए थे. 2005 में दे डिसाइडेड टू सेटअप ए 30,000 करोर फैक्ट्री. फिर 2015 में बिकॉज दे हैड द प्रोस्पेक्टिंग लाइसेंस, तो देवर एक्सेम्प्ट फ्रॉम दिस MDDR एक्ट, तो दे कूड हैव दिस कैप्टिव लाइसेंस. सर 2015 से स्टेट गवर्नमेंट भी रिकमेंड किए आपको, ये आपके माइनिंग मिनिस्ट्री में उनका फाइल 6 साल से पड़ा हुआ है, क्लियर नहीं हो रहा है. तो हम वहाँ पर आंदोलन करते हैं कि आप फैक्ट्री क्यों नहीं सेटअप कर रहे हो, बट वो बोल रहे हैं कि माइनिंग मिनिस्ट्री में 6 साल से ये पेंडिंग है, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट रिकमेंड किया है. नाउ यू आर चेंजिंग द लॉ, सो इफ यू ब्रिंग समवन वी एक्सपेक्ट दैट एटलीस्ट द पब्लिक हियरिंग, ग्राम सभा, ये सब आप जरूर कीजिएगा. एंड देयरफॉर सर ये बहुत ही संगीन मामला है. ये माइंस खाली सरकार को रेवेन्यू की बात नहीं है, ये हम आदिवासियों को, हम जितने मतलब पीड़ित लोग हैं, हम लोग के जिंदगी के सवाल है. एंड माइंस हैज नेवर वर्क्ड इन एदर ऑस्ट्रेलिया और साउथ अफ्रीका, जो भी बोल रहे हैं माननीय सदस्य. आई डोंट एग्री दैट इट इज सक्सेसफुल मॉडल इन एदर ऑस्ट्रेलिया साउथ अफ्रीका, बट इन इंडिया वी डोंट हैव एन ऑप्शन. आई बिलीव दैट विद योर मिनिस्ट्री एंड एवरीथिंग यू कम अप विद सम अल्टरनेट ऑप्शन इंस्टेड ऑफ सेलिंग आवर रिजर्व्स, इफ वी कैन रियली वर्क कि हम कैसे कर पाए इसको, और रेगुलेट कीजिएगा और कंट्रोल कीजिएगा. बिकॉज जो ह्यूमन एंगल है, जो ह्यूमन इंडेक्स है, जो आदिवासी लोग, हम लोग वहाँ बसे हुए हैं, हम लोग बस कुछ ऑप्शन ही नहीं है. सर आप अभी चलता है ग्राम सभा वगैरह, माइनिंग हो गया, DMF हो गया, यू गिव एम्प्लॉयमेंट समबड़ी, फिर हम बेघर हो जाते हैं, हमारी जमीन चली जाती है. एंड हम देखे हैं एग्जाम्पल्स, बहुत सारे PSUs भी है जहाँ हम जमीन दे के लड़ाई किए थे. बट ऑल दिस जितना भी एजिटेशन है, दिस ऑलवेज सरप्राइज. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट द गवर्नमेंट टू रिकंसिडर दिस पर्टिकुलर बिल. आप एक जॉइंट कमेटी को भेजिए जहाँ पे मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट भी हो, ट्राइबल मिनिस्टर हो, आपके मिनिस्ट्री हो, एंड देन जितने MPs वगैरह जो ट्राइबल MPs है और जो माइनिंग अफेक्टेड एरियाज में MPs है, उनको ये बिल भेज के फिर से आप विचार विमर्श कीजिएगा. एंड देखिए कैसे एक लॉन्ग लास्टिंग बिल लेके आया जिसमें हम आदिवासी लोग का भी आप जीवन का संरक्षण कर सकते हो, हमारे एनवायरनमेंट का प्रोटेक्शन कर सकते हो, जो दूषित होता है, लाइक जो रिजर्व होता है उसको कैसे बचा के इसको मॉनिटर करेंगे. वी आर नॉट अगेंस्ट माइनिंग एंड ऑपरेशंस, बट वी आर अगेंस्ट द वे द हैस्टी ऑक्शंस विच यू आर डूइंग. जो एक ऑक्शन के बाद ये आप बड़े बड़े प्लेस को लेके आओगे, दे वॉन्ट लुक इन टू द वेलबींग ऑफ द पीपल. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट सर प्लीज स्टैंड दिस टू अ सेलेक्ट कमिटी ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स, फॉरेस्ट एंड एनवायरमेंट एंड आपके मंत्रालय प्लस सम MPs, यू फॉर्म ए जॉइंट कमिटी एंड देन लेट्स डिस्कस दिस वंस अगेन. थैंक यू.